Hello friends, today we will discuss with the topic capacitance voltage divider and impulse voltage divider. What is the importance of capacitance voltage divider in the system as well as impulse voltage divider in the system? Let us see. So, capacitance voltage divider. The capacitance voltage divider are ideal for measurement for fast rising voltages and pulses. Means in a system when there will be a disturbances, so that time the pulses are created. The transient in the system unbalance the voltage, so rise in voltage occurs. So that time we are using a capacitance voltage divider. So in that case, the capacitance ratio is independent of the frequency. Means it is not depend on the frequency, it is independent on the frequency. If their leakage resistance is high enough to be neglected, but usually the dividers are connected to the source voltage through long leads which introduce lead inductance and residual resistances. So these divider are connected in the system such a way that the source voltage through long leads which introduce source voltage through long leads means the applied voltage. This will be connected to the applied voltages which will include a inductances in the system and residual resistances in the system. So, the capacitance used for very high voltage work is not small in dimension and hence cannot be considered as lump element. So, what are the lump element? Resistance, capacitance and inductance. So, in that case, when there will be a more size capacitors are there or the voltage level is high, the capacitance must be taken into account. Therefore, the output of the divider can be given by a pure capacitance divider for high voltage measurement and its electrical equivalent network without stray element is shown. This is the capacitance voltage divider for very high voltages. This is the capacitor. This is the source CHV which can be impinged through capacitor C1, and the output form which is independent of frequency can be get on the CRO. So the ratio can be divider given as alpha is equal to V1 of T upon V2 of T, which is 1 plus C2 upon C1. So, capacitance C1 form between the HV terminal of the source and that of test object or any other point of measurement. The CRO is located within the shielded screen surrounding the capacitance C2. So, C2 includes the capacitance used, the lead capacitance, input capacitance of CRO and other ground capacitance. So, C2 affect the three. First one is the lead capacitance. Second one, the capacitance outside the stray means it is counted as a ground capacitances and input capacitance of the CRO. So, the advantage of this connection is that the load on the source is negligible. Means, in this potential divider system or capacitance divider system, the load is negligible. But small disturbances in the location of C or HV electrode or the presence of any stray object nearby changes the capacitor CI. Means the lead capacitance, that is incoming capacitance, can be changes if the changes can be done in HV electrode. And hence divider ratio is affected obviously. So in many cases a standard air or compressed gas capacitor is used which has coaxial cylinder construction. Accurate ratio that could be calculated up to 1000 upon 1 and that can be achieved for maximum impulse voltage of 350 kV and upper frequency limit is about 10 megahertz for small or moderate high voltage up to 100 kV. So these capacitance voltage divider are used for the ratio of 1000 to 1. Maximum impulse limit will be 350 kV. Frequency used will be 10 megahertz and the voltages are for up to 100 kV, that is system voltages. And the capacitance divider are built with an upper frequency limit of 200 megahertz. This is the special characteristics of the capacitance voltage divider. So another type of design frequently used to make C1 to consist of several capacitance C1 in series for the given voltage V1. In such cases, the equivalent circuit is like that of the string insulator unit. String insulator unit, we know. The voltage distribution along the capacitor chain is non-linear, means the voltage distribution where we are using capacitor in the transmission line are not uniformly distributed. There some kind of disturbances definitely occur as capacitance is there and hence causes the distribution of the output wave. But the ratio error is constant and is independent of frequency as compared with the resistance dividers. A simplified equivalent circuit is shown, which can be given as C1 is very much less than C2 and CG, that is ground capacitance, is very much less than C1. The voltage ratio can be given as alpha is equal to V1 upon V2, which is equal to 1 plus C2 upon C1 into 1 plus CG upon 6 C1, that is number of capacitance are connected in series. So the ratio is constant and gives an error of less than 5%. Hence C1 is equal to 3 CG. The equivalent circuit is quite satisfactory up to 1 MHz, means that system will be used for up to the 1 MHz system frequency. And this is the schematic circuit diagram of cathode ray oscilloscope voltage divider probe. This is the HV conductor or the HV terminal. This is capacitor C1, that is shield capacitor in parallel with resistance R1. This is CM, that is capacitance under the CRO, which can be parallel with the R2. This is the input stage. In the resistance potential divider, R1, R2 are considered as resistor of small dimension in the previous section. For voltages above 100 kV, R1 is no longer small in dimension and usually made of several sections. Hence, the divider is no longer a small resistor of lump parameters but must consider as an equivalent distributed network with its terminal grounded capacitance and intersectional series capacitance as shown. Means R1 is not considered in case if the voltage level is above 100 kV. So, it cannot be treat as a lump parameter. It will do the calculation with the help of that particular value. The R1 value matters in this case when the voltage is above 100 kV. So the total series resistance R1 is made on resistance of value R1 dash and R is equal to N into R1 dash. CG is the terminal to ground capacitance of each of the resistance R1 dash and CS is the capacitance between terminal of each section. The inductance of each element is not shown in the figure as it is usually compared to the other element. This type of divider produces a non-linear voltage distribution along its length and acts like RC filter for applied voltages. So the output of such divider for various CG, means ground capacitance and series capacitance ratio, for step input by arranging guard rings at various element point, the equivalent circuit can be modified as shown, which can be shown in this type of figure, means resistance potential divider with intersectional and ground capacitance. This is the ground capacitance, number of capacitance are connected in parallel as well as connected in resistance connected in parallel. This is the HV electrode and this is the output of the divider shown in the step input waveform, which can be plotted against voltage V and microsecond, that is capacitance in microfarad, and that will represent the stray capacitance introduced between the high voltage lead and the guard element, that is guard ring. This reduces the distortion introduced by the original divider. This is the guard ring. That kind of guard structure is there, which is similar to the previous equivalent circuit of the ground capacitance and the stray capacitance, means capacitance at the input. So this is about the capacitance voltage divider and impulse voltage resistance divider, which can simply can be used to limit the impulse voltage value in the system to keep the system balanced. Thank you.